Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Chaitanya Charitamrita Anta Lila, 3rd chapter, verse number 51. If you have any mobile, you can switch it. Anta Lila, chapter 3,
verse number 51. Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivaradhari Shodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yashodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tiravana Chariyam Yamuna Tira Vanachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Louder. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Jaya Gauranitai, 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 Gauranitai. Jagannatha, Jagannatha, Baladeva Jai Subhadra. Jai Jai Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Prabhupada Jai Srila Prabhupada. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Just nikal denge to acha. Great.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
So this is a humble attempt to assist Srila Prabhupada in the World Holy Name Week. As you know, all over the world in ISKCON, we are celebrating from 17th of this month till 24th, or some place till 25th, World Holy Name Festival. Devotees are encouraged to chant more and more and discuss about the Holy Name, take Harinam procession, because this is actually the root of all devotional activities. Lord Chaitanya himself said, Taramade Sarvashreshta Nama Sankirtan Niraparade Nama Laye Pai Premadhan. The translation is that among all the different activities of devotional service, the Sarvashreshta, the supreme, is the chanting of the holy names. And one who offenselessly, attentively chants the holy name, he attains pure love for Krishna. So, of course, actually every week is a holy name week. Every day is our festival. But specifically we celebrate 1 week a year just immediately after Haridas Thakur's disappearance day, so as to focus the attention. All activities are very wonderful in devotional service, but chanting of the holy name is what makes the activities devotional service. If the chanting of the holy name is not there, then the activities become ordinary activities. Like I am cooking, I am driving or doing business. If I actually am chanting the holy name, then that activity becomes devotional service. And if I am not chanting properly, then that activity simply becomes a mechanical activity. You find sometimes devotees, after years of practicing Krishna consciousness, they become somewhat disappointed, sometimes they leave the movement, sometimes they become even inimical to the practice of devotional service. So because they may have somehow missed the point, we have to be careful of what is the real point. The real point of life is to develop pure love for Krishna, and the means to develop is to chant the holy name. It is as simple as that. Goal is to develop love for Krishna, confirmed by Lord Jagannath. And the means to develop that goal is to chant Hare Krishna. But if you know these two things, that I am a servant of Krishna, I must chant Hare Krishna, do whatever, you will go back to God. Otherwise, if you forget this, you may become JBC also. You become big sannyasi, or you may become big guru also. If you forget this point, that I am a servant of Krishna, what is my duty? I have to chant Hare Krishna. And other thing, whatever I can do, whether I can clean the floor, I can do the aarti, or I can distribute books, that is, does not matter. Like I have to go from here to Hyderabad on Monday, so all I need to know is that I should have a ticket and I should know the way to the airport. I may not wrote the entire Bangalore city. But in fact, if I know the entire Bangalore city, the chances that I may miss the airport. Because I may go to the different malls, so many illusions. So to keep the goal straight. Like Mahabharata, we find that story of, you know, Dronacharya is testing the Pandavas and the Kurus, and he wants to know who is most qualified, and gives the object, one bird, one toy bird, says, please aim at the eye of the bird. So everyone is called one by one. First Duryodhan comes, because he is so humble, he thinks I am the most qualified. So he says, I am the one, you know. Says, put your heart. And then they ask him, Duryodhan, what do you see? I see the bird, I see the leaves, I see you also. So Dronacharya says, okay, now take, you are not qualified. So finally, when Arjuna turns comes, Arjuna, just focus attention on the bird. What do you see? I see the bird. No. I see the leaves. No. I only see the eye of the bird. And that's perfect. So you must keep the focus very clear. So if focus is clear, you may do everything in life. If you are a family man, you have so many responsibilities. Brahmachari also preaching and so many responsibilities. But the goal is to chant. So when the time of death comes, when you become old, then you don't feel disappointed. Sometimes devotees feel disappointed. Now I'm old, I cannot do much practical service. But the most practical service is to chant. The practice should be so nice that by the time we become, let's say, 60 plus, we have already reached the level of pure chanting. And come at least to 40 rounds, 50 rounds per day. Every year, if you calculate, and every year we increase one or two rounds. Like, what is your age, Sir Prabhupada? 22. So if you increase one round per day, then by the time you are 62, you will be coming to 50 rounds at least. You know. So this is a good practice. You know. Or those who are more than 22, you can do two rounds per year. Like I am already 57 now. So for me, I am doing 32, so I have to increase four rounds per year. Then I can, by the time I am 70, I can come. It's a good idea, Ashokar Prabhu. What do you think? We can try. Because after all, everything is incremented. Like, if you see those of you are working, the salary which you are getting, Nandana Chaprabhu, how many years you have been working?
21
years. So, can you compare the salary you were getting 20 years back and now? Is it the same or increase a little bit? Increase 100% more at least, ne? Correct? The same way, the japa you were doing 10 years back is 16. So, there should be some increment, ne? But it's the time of everything, rates are going high. So we should try to increase more and more. Both quality and quantity. Sometimes devotees argue that I can increase my quality, that is more important. So I agree with that. Quality is more important than quantity. But if you can do quantity, then quality will improve. If you do quality, then quantity will improve. So at least like here in Bangalore, I know many wonderful devotees are here. Many devotees chant 32 rounds on Ekadashi, many chant 64. So, according to our capacity, we have to increase. Actually, Japada Swami Maharaj, he keeps, apart from his japa beads, he keeps a counter with him so that whenever he gets time, he goes on chanting. We are all very fortunate that next week he is coming here. So, take advantage of his association. And the way to prepare for his coming is to chant more and more. One of the devotees was telling me that Sri Japada Swami Maharaj wrote a letter to the disciples that please make sure you are chanting 16 rounds attentively, and that's the best thing you do for the Guru Maharaj's health also. Because one thing is provide medical facilities, that is good, but the best thing you can do to please your spiritual master, maybe, or any representative of Prabhupada, is to chant very sincerely. In one purport in the Adi Lila, Prabhupada tells the story of Ishwarapuri. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is talking to Prakashananda Saraswati. And Prakashananda Saraswati is inquiring that you are not coming with us for any discussions on Vedanta Sutra. We have conferences, you know, Mayavadi conferences. Why do you attend this? Swami Bhogananda is calling, you know, say Prakashananda. So he says that I don't attend any of these conferences because I don't read Vedanta. Why don't you read Vedanta Sutras? Because my Guru Maharaj told me that I am a fool. I am a fool. And don't read Vedanta, just chant Hare Krishna. The Prabhupada writes in the purport that Lord Chaitanya is not a fool. He defeated big pundits. Digvijay Keshav Kashmiri was like the top pundit. Digvijay means conqueror. You are like 5-star rating, you know. If you give him the rating in pundit. But Lord Chaitanya defeated him. Sarvam Bhattacharya, another great pundit. Lord Chaitanya defeated him. But he's saying, I'm a fool. Once you think I'm a fool, then you can chant nicely. You think I'm... Fool means F-O-L, fool, not flower. If you think I'm a nice flower, then you will not. So, you should think I'm a fool. So one devotee was telling me that your lecture is wonderful. You know? So I said, by the mercy of Guru, a fool can become wonderful. You know? So I'm a fool. But by the Guru, mercy. Actually, we cannot do anything. I cannot even open my lips without the mercy of Guru. So we can never be proud. We can never be proud. Why? Because I can't do anything without mercy of God. So Lord Chaitanya told, I am a fool. And my Guru Maharaj told me, chant Hare Krishna. I started chanting. And there were tears coming out of my eyes. And my body was shivering in ecstasy. And then I went back to my Guru Maharaj. Kiba mantra dila gosai. What kind of mantra are you giving me? Japite japite haila pagal. I am becoming madman. Is it some wrong mantra? And my Guru Maharaj said, Bhala Haila. This is very good. You have attained the right result. Like the doctor gives you medicine, if there are symptoms, and then you tell him, I took this medicine, and suddenly, like sometimes you take Ayurvedic medicines and you have complete clearing of the body. So the doctor says, what medicine you have given? The doctor says, very good. Now your body will function better. So this Hare Krishna mantra is in a sincere chanter, we experience that ecstasy. And now my Guru Maharaj is very happy and he says, go and distribute this mantra. The Prabhupada writes in the purport, the greatest joy for a spiritual master, for Prabhupada or for any of his descendants, is when the disciple chants Hare Krishna seriously and develops taste for the holy. And Prabhupada writes, the spiritual master is not pleased if the disciple simply brings money. Sometimes you think, I'll give my Guru Maharaj 10 lakh rupees. Guru Maharaj, 16 rounds difficult, I chant 8 rounds and I'll give 8 lakhs, you know, balance. Once devotee said, Prabhupada, I have no time, I feel very sleepy during japa. Prabhupada said, all right, you sleep 22 hours, no problem, but chant 2 hours. Because that doesn't mean we should do that, but that is another extreme. You know. I remember I was in Bombay when Prabhupada was on this planet, the last year, 1977. And Prabhupada was telling one devotee, he was like, you know, visiting girls, the devotee, he was coming sometime for morning program. Prabhupada said, I will give you free room here, you stay in the temple and just chant and that's all. So Prabhupada would encourage like this, you know, that I will give you all facilities, just chant. So don't think that chanting is something, you know, oh, it's meant for old people, you know, now let me do something. Kuch karke dikhana hai mujhe. I want to show that I am not ordinary devotee. So the biggest thing you can do for pleasing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is come before you leave your body, come to the level where you are chanting with tears in your eyes. Genuine tears, not hypocritical. With tears begging, Krishna, please accept me. I am very, very low class. I am very fallen, degraded, worthless, destitute. Please accept me, Krishna. If once you can even say to Krishna like this, I am yours. I have surrendered to you. Please accept me. Please, 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 please. You have to actually cry and beg. Then once you can chant like this, then yeah, life is perfect. But of course, to come to that level may take time. That's why we practice devotional service. And that's why this World Holy Name Week is there. I'm grateful to all the devotees who gave me this opportunity. Our Mathura Shyam Prabhu suggested this topic for the World Holy Name Week. And if you can, I would suggest, of course, we have already passed 2-3 days. It is the 4th day, 17th of the World Holy Name Week. So we still have 4 days. So these 4 days we can try to chant at least 32 rounds the weekend, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and as per capacity, and read about the glories of the Holy Name. So with that in mind, I have selected one verse today for discussion. This is a conversation between Lord Chaitanya and Haridas Thakur. Now we are going into Gaurlila in that section where Lord Chaitanya has taken sannyas and is in Jagannath Puri already. And Haridas Thakur was not allowed in the temple, but Lord Chaitanya made a small bhajan kutir for him. He planted a seed and a beautiful bakula tree came up. And Lord Chaitanya told that you can look at the chakra, because you're not allowed. Look at the chakra of Jagannath and chant. And that is as good as seeing the Lord. So this is seeing Lord Jagannath, or seeing the chakra is non-different. Like some of our leaders in ISKCON who are born in the Western countries, they are not allowed inside. So I was in one yatra with His Holiness Radhana Swami Maharaj. And he gave 2.5 hour lecture, and then after the lecture he told, "You are also fortunate who are born in India, you can go and see Lord Jagannath. I am not so fortunate." But then he said, Haridas Thakur was not allowed, Sanatana Goswami was not allowed, Rupa Goswami was not allowed. So I am in good company. Srila Jayapada Swami Maharaj also not allowed, you know. They allowed, right? Inside the temple. They don't allow the devotees born in Western countries. But here we see, if you are sincerely chanting, Lord Himself comes out. Haridas Thakur is sitting, he is not allowed. But Lord Jagannath is coming out in the form of Lord Chaitanya. Patit Pavan, yes, that is. So, but Lord Jagannath is coming out in the form of Lord Chaitanya. In other words, if you chant nicely, Lord will come out. If you are not chanting, you may go to Jagannath and see, and then go to Anand Bazaar. Anand Sepasana, my favorite place also. You know. But really, seeing Lord Jagannath means chanting the Holy Name. So, one day Lord Chaitanya came to Haridas Thakur and started some discussion. And this is where we are beginning today. I would also recommend devotees to read this book. I don't know, we have more copies of this book. I think this was the last copy, Chanting Hare Krishna. It is not a new book, it has been around for more than 5 years. But unfortunately, very few copies were available. So this book has been reprinted in Bombay. In fact, this book cost around 250 rupees. But the reprint is a simple paper, so it costs 70 or 80 rupees. So anybody who wants, please, you can give me your name and phone number, and I will send copies from Bombay. They have reprinted this. This has got all the quotations of Prabhupada on the Holy Name. Like, actually, there are two books. This is, one is Namamrit. This I think most devotees already have. This is much older, and this is general book, but this is specially for those who want to like graduation. This is post graduation, so this book is specially for those devotees who want to like just focus and get all the tips, like, you know, like we have how to make idlis, how to learn Bengali, how to learn computer, this how to chant, you know, all the quotations of Prabhupada. And I will use this book as the basis for the next 4 or 5 lectures, today morning, evening, tomorrow morning, evening, and Sunday morning. So we will focus, and by the mercy of Prabhupada, we can get insight into the process of chanting. So we'll begin with the discussion. This is, if you have in your mobile, it is Ante Leela, chapter 3, verse 51. Verse 51. ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय प्लीज रिपीट आफ्टर मी इहा सबार को न मते हैबे निस्तार ताहर हेतु न देखिया ए दुख अपार इहा सबार को न मते हई बे निस्तार ताहर हेतु न देखिया ए दुख अपार इहा सबार कोन मते हई बे निस्तार ताहर हेतु न देखिया ए दुख अपार Sabara of all these Yavanas. Kona mate, by which way? Haibe nistara will be deliverance. Tahara hetu, the cause of said deliverance. Na dekhiya, I do not see. E dukha apara, it is my great unhappiness. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada. Lord Chaitanya is speaking this verse to Srila Haridas Thakur. How will this Yavanas be delivered to my great unhappiness? I do not see any way. Purport. This verse reveals the significance of Lord Sri Chaitanya's appearance as Patita Pavan, the deliverer of the fallen souls. Shri Narottam Das Thakur sings, Patita pavana hetu tava avatara. O my Lord, you appeared just to deliver all the fallen souls. Mosama patita prabhu na pai be ara. And among all the fallen souls, I am the lowest. How Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was always thinking about the deliverance of the fallen souls is shown by the statement, E dukha apar. It is my great unhappiness. The statement indicates that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna Himself, is always very unhappy to see the fallen souls in the material world. Therefore, He Himself comes as He is, or He comes as a devotee in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. To deliver Krishna directly to the fallen souls. Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna prema pradayate. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so merciful that He not only gives knowledge of Krishna, but by His practical activities teaches everyone how to love Krishna. Krishna prema pradayate. Those who are following in the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu should take the Lord's mission most seriously. In this age of Kali, the people are gradually becoming less than animals. Nevertheless, although they are eating the flesh of cows and are envious of Brahminical culture, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is considering how to deliver them from this horrible condition of life. Thus, He asks all Indians to take up His mission. Bharat bhumi te haile manushya janma jara janma sardaka kori kara para upakara. One who has taken his birth as a human being in the land of India, Bharat Varsh, should make his life successful and work for the benefit of all other people. Therefore, the duty of every advanced and cultured Indian to take this cause very seriously. All Indians should help the Krishna conscious movement in its progress to the best of their ability. Then they will be considered real followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Unfortunately, even some so-called Vaishnavas enviously refuse to cooperate with this movement, but instead condemn it in so many ways. We are very sorry to say that these people try to find fault with us, being unnecessarily envious of our activities. Although we are trying to the best of our ability to introduce the Krishna conscious movement directly into the countries of the Yavanas and Malechas. So Yavanas and Malechas are coming to us and becoming purified Vaishnavas who follow in the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. One who identifies himself as a follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu should feel like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who said, Iha sabare kona mate hai be nistara. How will the Yavanas be delivered? Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was always anxious to deliver the fallen souls because their fallen condition gave him great unhappiness. That is the platform on which one can propagate the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Om Agyanti Mirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha
Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yutaha Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavam Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamshcha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha Kalpataru Bhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Seek the mercy of Sri Guru Srila Prabhupada and all the previous acharyas and all the assembled devotees to speak about the glories of the holy name. The glories of the holy name cannot be understood by our process of mental speculation or even by reading bona fide shastras. But the glories of the holy name become revealed by the mercy of Guru, Vaishnavas, previous acharyas. Sometimes you find, like in the story of Ramchandra Khan, he was also a scholar, or actually not Ramchandra Khan, Gopal Chakravarti was a great scholar. He was arguing with Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was telling him the glories of the holy name, but he could not understand. Similarly, Gopinath Acharya was explaining to Sarvamatta Acharya that Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Lord, he is Krishna himself, through with evidence from Shastra, but Sarvamatta Acharya could not understand. So, understanding of the divine knowledge is dependent on the causeless mercy of the Lord coming through His devotees. To speak about the holy name or to understand the holy name, it is not an ordinary subject. Only when we become empowered by the Lord, we can understand a drop of the glories of the holy name. You and me, we may have heard so many lectures on the holy name, or we may have also spoken also. But to realize the glories of the holy name requires the causeless mercy of the Lord. If you could just understand even 1% of the glories of the holy name, you would become mad for the holy name. You would just be chanting all the time. It is the greatest gift of God. Bhakti Vinod Thakur says that in this material world, there are only two spiritual things. One is the Jivatma, the living being, who is eternally a part of God. And the second is the holy name of Krishna. The holy name of Krishna can connect the Jivatma to the Supreme Lord. It is a process. The process is so transcendental that in the beginning stage, we need the holy name. In the middle stage, you need the holy name. In the final stage, you need the holy name. And when you become liberated, when you go back to Godhead, there also we are chanting Hare Krishna. See, in the spiritual world, in Goloka Vrindavan, the gopis are also chanting Hare Krishna. Not with bead bags, but they are naturally chanting Hare Krishna. So, do not underestimate the glories of the holy name. It is the supreme activity, supreme religious activity for all mankind. Param Vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtan. If Ananta Shesha had 1,000 mouths, glorifies the holy name for thousands of years also, still he cannot understand fully the holy name. Now, I am not Ananta Shesha, and our time is coming to Anta already. You know, what can we speak? It's like taking a drop from the ocean. But by tasting that drop, we can get an idea of the ocean. And why we are discussing this is because the more you hear about the glories of the holy name, the more you get taste for chanting.
Srila Prabhupada explains that one should regularly hear about the holy name from the mouths of devotees or from the revealed scriptures. Sometimes, like in this case, the person speaking may not be qualified. Certainly I am not. But if he is speaking from the bona fide shastras, then it will have the desired effect. Our whole process of bhakti, like Srila Prabhupada wrote in one beautiful letter to a disciple, 99% of the spiritual advancement is dependent on chanting the holy name. That means everything else we do, maybe you know, we are doing book distribution, we are doing construction, we are cooking, and we are eating prasad, and we are doing business. That all comes under 1%, 99%. That's how much. Like suppose you want to invest your money in some bank or in mutual fund or in share market, you like to find out what are the returns, right? As soon as I said about this, everybody became awake, you know, very practical topic, you know. Where to put the money? I want to put 1,000 rupees, say after 1 year at least should become 1,500 rupees. No. Punjab National Bank may not give that much. No. So you want to find out, sometimes we put risks also. But the danger is if you take a higher option, then sometimes you lose money also. No. But here in Krishna consciousness, the holy name is something where definitely profit, no loss. So whatever time we invest in chanting Hare Krishna or hearing about holy name, that is our eternal bank account. It is the only account which is carry forward to next birth also. In case, hopefully, you will all make back home, back to Godhead in this life. That is my prayer and your prayer also for me. But even if we cannot make it, whatever we have done, that will carry forward. And to my knowledge, no other bank allows like this. Eh? Is there, I think, maybe SBI, nationalized banks, they allow 10%. Gopinath Prabhu is authority in this. No? Which bank they allow to take after death, you know? Is there any bank like that? No. At least I have not found in Maharashtra. Maybe Bangalore has some. You know? The only bank is the ATM, the all-time Mahamantra bank. You know? Just by chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Many times devotees ask me, Prabhuji, why do you always speak about holy name? You should speak something else also. So of course, anything else you speak is also good, but it will culminate in the holy name. So why not come to holy name directly, especially in this week? So here the question, the verse before this one is where Lord Chaitanya is asking a question to Haridas Thakur. And what is that question? Haridas, Kalikale Yavan Apar Go Brahmana Hinsakare Mahadurachar. In Kali Yuga, there are so many people who are eating cow's flesh. What to speak of them? Muslims, nowadays we find that even Hindus, many of them indulge in eating beef. And not only here, it's a shameful thing that this country of Bharatvarsha is exporting beef also. It's a sign of degradation. It is not just for money, you know, the people go to a certain extent. This is the land where the cow should be protected. You know, cow is namo brahmana devaya, go brahmana hitaya cha. But this land where Krishna appeared is becoming famous for exporting cow's flesh. Such a sad news. So, the real culture according to Prabhupada is how the cows are treated. If you want to know how advanced civilization is, how the cows are taken care of. When you go to villages, and people have small homes, and even that sometimes they keep cows. Mother's place, there's still cows there. You know. Earlier I had gone to Gopinath Pran Prabhu's in-law's place and mother taking care of cows. But now of course with age not so practical. So you find in many farm projects like in our Govardhan Eco Village in Bombay and in our ISKCON Vrindavan also, Goshala, hundreds of cows. If you go to the Goshala, you feel so great joy. But now, if you see in the cities, especially Bombay, and there are the worst slaughterhouses. So now, can you imagine who would like to worry about these cow killers? Suppose I tell you that some cow killer is suffering from cancer or dying. You say, okay, I would think, okay, my God, let him be aparadi. Who will care for such a sinful person? But here you find Lord Chaitanya is asking about them. He is worried about them. What to speak of being worried about devotees? He is asking Haridas Thakur that, Iha Sabare Kon Mate Habe Nistar. Today's verse is asking, how will such people be delivered? That shows the extent of Lord Chaitanya's mercy. His mercy is not only to those who are pious Saraswat Brahmins or those who are wearing tilak and chanting 16 rounds, but he is worried about the lowest of men. It's like a mother or a father. He may have two children. One is studying very nicely, very obedient, and the other turns out to be a duffer and disobedient, engaging in frivolous activities. But still, the mother and father, they are concerned equally about the naughty, disobedient child. Sometimes the child may be mentally retarded, or the child may be, you know, having so many faults. The Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Father. Aham Bija Prada Pita is the father of all living beings. So he is showing concern for all. And he is asking, how will they be delivered? So in the purport, Prabhupada writes here that this is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. He is Patita Pavan. One qualification for chanting the holy name, the prime qualification, is to accept that I am Patita. I am degraded. Actually, we are all. Prabhupada says the qualification in Kali Yuga, majority of the people, they are degraded. In fact, Prabhupada says everybody is more or less Jagai and Madhai. Hare Krishna, all glories to all of us. Prabhupada is being very candid, very frank. Like somebody asked Prabhupada, what is our qualification? We are participating in the Harinam Sankirtan. This Harinam Kirtan is non-different from the Ras Leela of the Lord. The same Ras Leela where Krishna is dancing with the gopis is taking place in Kali Yuga in Navadvip, where Lord Chaitanya is dancing with all his associates, Nityananda, Advaita, Gadadhar, and chanting the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. So how, what is our qualification? Prabhupada says the same, this ISKCON society is an extension of the Sankirtan movement. So taking part in this ISKCON movement is as good as taking part in Lord Chaitanya's mission. So what is our qualification for participating in this mission? Even demigods are eager, but they are not always allowed. So what did Prabhupada reply? Prabhupada didn't say, oh, you are all good, you are all born in Bharatvarsha. Prabhupada said very frankly, you have no qualification. I created your qualification. The pure devotee just glances at you. That also is a sukriti. Just meet a pure devotee accidentally. Like, you know, one person who was, he saw one advertisement of Prabhupada with, you know, Srila Prabhupada wearing a watch, very special watch. And he became attracted to the watch. Watch the watch. He was thinking that, maybe I should get this watch. But how to get? You can't just jump in. You have to become close associate of Prabhupada to get the watch. So he joined the temple, Hare Krishna. He joined the temple in Bombay, Radha Rasbihari temple, at that time just started. But then he came to know Prabhupada is not in Bombay, he's in Hyderabad. Or I don't remember, Hyderabad or some city, yeah, Hyderabad. Prabhupada was going to Hyderabad regularly. And then he went all the way with train, with the ticket paid by the temple to go to Hyderabad to steal the watch. Hare Krishna. And then he came to listen to Prabhupada's lecture, just sitting very close, like same Prakash Prabhu. I also have a watch, but I'm not Prabhupada. I'm not that advanced, and you are not that. So he was just watching at the watch, and by the time he heard Prabhupada's half an hour, 45 minutes lecture, his mind was transformed. He said, why should I engage in this infinite with the great sadhu? Rather, I should serve. He decided that I'll join the movement, and I already joined, but I'll join now genuinely. As soon as the lecture got over, he offered obeisances to Prabhupada. He came near and Prabhupada took out his watch. Paramatma within the heart, you know. Pure devotee can understand. And then of course he became great. He's still doing very wonderful service in his ISKCON. So of course, not in a mood of criticizing, but what it shows is that Just even a moment's association with pure devotee can bring one to perfection. By chanting of the holy name, we do not have so much time, but maybe 2-3 months later, I'll again take a seminar which is, this is an introductory seminar. I was not expecting such good response, you know, maybe today being Friday, I was thinking Saturday, Sunday, more devotees may come. So maybe next time or maybe tomorrow itself, I want to take this book called Harinam Chintamani. Harinam Chintamani is a direct instruction of Lord Chaitanya, direct speech of Haridas Thakur to Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya is asking questions on how to improve japa. It's like a seminar, crash course by Haridas Thakur. And Lord Chaitanya is audience. I don't know whether we have this book in our stall here, but in some temple in Bombay, there are some books. It's a translation of Harinam Chintamani. And if you have got this book at home, maybe you can read it if you get time. There, many, many things are there, but I'm just kind of touching the important points. One of the points Lord Haridas Thakur suggests is that to chant the holy name properly, we should chant in the association of devotees, especially in association of those devotees who are attached to the holy name. We should honor and respect all devotees, but crave and seek and try to be with devotees who are attached to the holy name. Because the more we associate with such devotees, we get taste also. That's why we chant together. In fact, tomorrow we are thinking that there will be a class Bhagavatam like this, maybe start at 8. Tomorrow we can start at sharp at 8, but today because some of the demigods came late, so we started a little late. But tomorrow is Saturday, many people have office off, or you can make it off. And we start sharp at 8, so we try to end by 9:30. Today we started late, so we are going a little longer. And then after a little breakfast, for those of you it's possible, we will do a yagya of chanting till noon, till 1 o'clock. For tomorrow in some temples like our Whitefield ISKCON, they are planning 64 nam yagya. So they invited me also, but I thought if devotees here are interested, then I'll continue here if there's not much interest. Because this, once a month I suggest like we all come together and chant a little extra. May not happen to 64, whatever you can do till 1 o'clock. 64 is difficult, at least we can come to 40. But aim for 64. Like Prabhupada would say, you should aim very high, aim, shoot for the rhinoceros. You should aim for the moon, so you may reach the treetop at least. So aim very high, you know. It is not depressing, oh I could not achieve, but at least try. But if you aim only for 20, you will reach maximum 20. If you aim for 64, you may reach 32, 40. So how many of you feel it's practical that tomorrow after Bhagavatam class we can chant a little extra? Or is it better tomorrow or on Sunday? Which is better? Tomorrow will be better, because Sunday there are so many temple activities also, so many counselors meeting and other things. So I have found one thing, my own experience in chanting. Every year I go to Mayapur during the GBC meetings. I'm not GBC, I'm not even close to GBC, but I go for the GBC meetings just for chanting with the senior devotees in the morning time. And that gives me great spiritual strength. They'll find all the leaders of ISKCON, advanced devotees, they are together chanting in the morning. And that 1.5 to 2 hours of chanting is very nourishing. So, whenever and wherever possible, we should come together to chant. It is very difficult to chant all alone. At least you must find one devotee that, you know, if you feel sleepy, he or she will be awake. You know, very little probability that both will fall asleep at the same time. You know, if my probability of sleeping is, let's say, 1/4. Chance, 25%, and Swayam Prakash Prabhu is also 1/4, then the chances that both of us will fall asleep becomes 1/16, right? Probability theory, it's a very little chance. And if you have 10 devotees, then very little chance. And we should not feel discouraged when somebody wakes us up. I asked this question once in Bombay to Maharaj that, you know, if some senior devotee is sleeping, should we wake him up or not? What is your answer? Ashok Gaur Prabhu, what is your answer? Yes. So Maharaj replied that if some senior devotee is drowning in the ocean, will you pull him out or not? Oh no, boy, he's too senior, let him drown. Of course, we should do in such a way that it does not feel bad. Earlier, you know, once we had tried in Bombay, we had one big syringe, you know, like, and some one devotee would go around in the morning and if somebody's sleeping, then he would get a good bath, you know, second time bathing, cool water. But that was not very practical because, you know, temple room and everybody's. So one thing I found useful is, like I'm chanting, suppose I find that somebody is sleeping, then we just chant as if we have not noticed, but Hare Krishna, just look, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. So he gets up and doesn't know what happened. Or if he is very close to you, then you can even touch and wake. But believe me or not, more than 50% devotees, including myself, have this problem of sleeping during japa. And we are talking about Nayanam Galada Shudharaya, when tears will come out. So the first step is when my eyes will be open in chanting. Nayanam Unmilitam, you know. So it is a struggle. And even for very, very senior devotees, it is a struggle. So you may say, Prabhupada, why is it like this? Because Durdaivam Idrisham Iha Janina Nuraga. We have no attachment to the Holy Name. And you know, this sentence, Durdaivam Idrisham Nanuraga, if you find there are two different translations. One is a translation every day we read in Shikshashtakam. Oh my dear Lord, you have millions of names like Krishna, Govinda, in all these names you invested all your energies, but I am so unfortunate that I have no attraction for the Holy Name. Correct? That is the translation. But if you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, the Shikshashtakam verses come in 20th chapter, last chapter of last Antyalila. And there Prabhupada translates, oh my Lord, because I commit offenses, that is why I do not have any taste for the Holy Name. In other words, because of offenses. For those of you who are interested, I have also started one every day, 1:30 to 2 in the afternoon, Chaitanya Charitamrita reading class for office goers or even housewives are also, some of them are there. Those who are free in the afternoon for half hour, that we just do a reading together. Or you can do it in your own group. You can form a group where everybody has a book and Skype, you know. So you can put it in a audio format. So, you know, because office, you may not like everybody to know what. So just put in audio format and everybody reads one verses and discusses. So yesterday we were discussing this verse. And Durdaivam Idrisham Iha Janina Anuraga. So why I don't have taste for the Holy Name? Why Rupa Goswami, what does Rupa Goswami say about the Holy Name? When I chant the Holy Name, I desire, when I utter the two syllables, Krishna, please say Krishna.
Krishna.
Then what happens? I desire to have millions of tongue. And when the name enters into my ear, Krishna, I desire to have millions of ears. Now why I don't feel like that? The Holy Name is same. Because of offenses. Now, how to overcome offenses? We will be discussing this very shortly from this book, Chanting Hare Krishna. But the most important way is constantly chant. Constant chanting frees one from all offenses. It's what Prabhupada writes in the purport. You know that famous verse of Prahlad Maharaj where he talks about the 9 processes of devotional service? What is that verse? Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam. Have you read the purport to that verse? The purport is very interesting. In the purport to that verse, Prabhupada gives a purport to each item. For Shravanam, 2 pages. For Kirtanam, 2 pages. For like that, 5-6 pages purport. But, it is 7.5.23. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada, Sevanam. I knew somebody would ask. I memorized the verse number before. So that verse Prabhupada writes in the purport that no matter what you do, you cannot overcome offenses. Prabhupada said, there is no means. They said, Prabhupada, then what should we do? Then Prabhupada writes, the only way to atone is to chant Hare Krishna 24 hours. Or at least try to chant. So we should make an attempt at. We can chant on mala 16 rounds, then on fingers or on counters or on the mind. Make an attempt. As I said, if you try for 24 hours, you may reach 2.4 hours. 10. At least 16 rounds is 2 hours. You know. And everything, like how do we learn walking? Some of you remember your Bali Leela, how you learned walking. You know. Very few of us just got up from the mother's lap and just started walking on an Olympic race. You know, we fall down. Many times we walk with the mother or father's hand in hand. We fall to the ground. Sometimes we get wounded also. You know. But still, we try. The chanting is a lifetime exercise. It can happen in one birth, but usually it takes many births to attain perfection. But if you are sincere and serious and trying with full sincerity, then Krishna can do wonders. So this being a small group, I would pause for any comments or questions. Would anybody like to comment on what they heard about this topic from other senior devotees or from Prabhupada's books? We have 2 minutes. Yes, Prabhu. Yeah, that is a good idea. A little risky also. Because you may get up at 8 o'clock, you know. Best thing is to take timely rest. Like the first day I came here, I was very, very tired. And Gopinath Prabhu was, you know, he was lovingly telling me after the lecture. I gave lecture also. And I started at 3 classes and then flight from Bombay. And then, so I could not chant. But yesterday night, I got at least 5 hours rest, 10:30 to 3:30. And I'm feeling a little better. So best is, there's no substitute for rest. If you don't take proper rest, you will rest in japa. That is unavoidable. Even if you're a very advanced devotee, your body is a machine. The body needs, like your car will be BMW or a Fortune, but every car needs maintenance. You can't say my car is 25 lakh rupees, so I keep running for 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. It will crash. So you have to be practical. This is what I learned the hard way. And hopefully all of you can learn the normal way. Of course, this taking rest proper is not a big problem. Many devotees are expert. They make it up in their classes also. You know. But there's an essential item. And second thing is to understand how important the holy name is. Just like next week we are expecting Shri Japata Swami Maharaj. Devotees are eager to meet him and hear from him. It's very unlikely that somebody is sitting very close to Guru Maharaj and at the same time he falls asleep. It's very unlikely. Suppose some prime minister or some big official is visiting our temple. We are very careful to honor him properly. You know, is it possible that some big person is coming, you welcome him in the temple and then you go to the next room and take rest? You know? So we are not actually understanding how great is the holy name. If we knew even 1% of the glories of the holy name, we'd be wide awake. Like, you know, have you seen how people count their money, businessmen, you know, when they're counting in the evening, it's like, sometimes, eyes coming out of the specs, you know. Anandam budhi vardhanam. Have you seen somebody fall asleep while he's counting money? Very unlikely, you know. Or somebody fall asleep while he's eating rasgulla or pizza, you know.
Two times counting.
Yeah. So, he knows the importance of the money. You cannot compare one holy name to 1 crore rupees is an offense actually. One holy name is worth the entire creation. And my experience is, you know, regarding wealth, because I travel a lot and I'm very intimate with many grihastha devotees. Some or other, whether you earn more or less, things continue the same way. I find people who earn less are more healthier sometimes than who earn more and are in anxiety. You know, so give whatever is needed time for office business. But chant more and more. Chant. Yes, Gopinath Prabhu, any comments? He is one of my partners in chanting many times. Because previously, when I had more time, we would go to Udupi or Melkote. That's another thing I am planning for those who are interested. That the 2 weeks from now, that is 5th and 6th of October, is a Saturday, Sunday. And then we combine it. 8th is Dashera or 7th is Dashera? 8th. So 7th, if we can take leave, you know, from the service of Maya Devi, so we can have 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. 4 days I'm planning to go with some devotees to Melkote, and all of you are also invited. You can come for 1 day also, or 2 days, as per your, in case you cannot take leave. Or some devotees are going only on 7th and coming back on 8th. You have to go out of your normal place of residence to chant extra rounds. Even Brahmachari, when you're staying in the temple, something other will come. And second thing, you have to be away from your very intimate partner, mobile Prabhu. Mobile has to be on switch of flight mode. Even if it's silent mode, periodically you will tend to see, you know. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. So that is a big distraction. I'm actually a victim to that. I'm trying to get out of it. Although for good purpose, I have to book my ticket, I have to be in touch with devotees, plan my program. And sometimes that is last minute, but not at the cost of chanting. In fact, I saw one very humorous WhatsApp message, you know. One devotee is having his bead bag and the finger he is putting here. Then a comment is there, if Prabhupada knew that mobiles will come, he would not make the bead bag like this, you know, where the finger comes out. So this is a major distraction for all ISKCON devotees. And I'm telling you, it's not easy to get out of it. It's an addiction. Just like there is alcohol addiction, there is mobile addiction. Even if there is nothing to do, people will just something or the other. Not the PUBG games, even elderly people, just some message. Somebody has not sent a message, we send a message, you know, something. So I'm not against it. It's part of social life. You cannot live without that. But not during chanting time. Okay, any other comments? Any Matajis would like to share something? Or any questions on this? Yes, Prabhu. What did he say?
Prabhupada created the qualification for his disciples. Right? But at a different time, he has said that my Guru Maharaj sent the two.
So there are different.
Tell me this moment.
Yeah. There are some devotees who are on that level also. Who are sent. At least for myself, the first one applies. And you should also think like that. You should not think I am among the ones who were sent by my Guru Maharaj. You should think I am just a fallen soul. I have no qualification. My mercy of my spiritual master lifted me up. Prahlad Maharaj is an advanced devotee. Who can be more advanced than Prahlad? What is he saying? He says, I was in a well which was filled with snakes. And my Guru Maharaj Narad Muni pulled me out. So I am eternally grateful to him. So whether you are actually in that category or whether you are in Prahlad's category, you should think I am in the lowest category. That way you will be more humble. See, chanting is proportional to humility. You know, the more you are humble, you unknowingly the name will appear on your tongue. The more you are proud, the name will not appear. And chanting is inversely proportional to pride. So we should cultivate this mood. Even Rup and Sanatan, they are the most exalted. They are descending from Gola Vrindavan. What is Rup and Sanatan saying? They are saying that we are more fallen than Jagai and Madai. And Jagai and Madai are serial killers. They are worse than terrorists. But Rup Sanatan, they are saying, I am more fallen than Jagai and Madai. So, what is our qualification? Prabhupada himself, when he writes his offerings to his Guru Maharaj, he is saying, he's called himself the most fallen. Kaviraj Goswami is saying, I am the most fallen. So, like, if you want to get a scholarship in school or college, generally they will ask, what is your father's income? Nee? They ask like that. So what should you say? Should you say more or less? You should say less. I use this formula also. You know? If you say, you know, I'm very much great income, then you will not get. Similarly, if you go before Krishna, Krishna, I'm very good devotee. You know, I'm actually one of your associates. And I just came here for helping you in the mission. By my causeless mercy, entire Bangalore, at least this temple is being benefited. So if you think like this, then Krishna will not see. Even if you are good at Mangalarti, attending programs, if you are proud of that, what is the value of that? Pride spoils everything. It's like you have made nice kheer with cashews and raisins and walnuts, and you just put, you know, 100 milliliter of Karela juice in it, or some sand particles, that will lose. The worst enemy for chanting is pride. That's why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, tomorrow I will be taking this verse where Lord Chaitanya takes a seminar on the holy name. Anybody knows where it is? It is in Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Lila, 17th chapter. He is taking a seminar in the house of Shuklamba Brahmachari with few devotees. And there he says, Urdva Bahu Kari. The Bahu means hand. I raise my hands and declare that this is the most important verse. And what is that verse? Trinada Pesanicha. He says, take this verse and tie it around your neck like Kanthi Mala, on the thread of the holy name. The thread and there are the beads. So Hare Krishna mantra the thread and Trinadapi Sunichena Tarori Vasaishna. I remember in Prabhupada's time, one very senior disciple of Prabhupada, she actually wore a Kanthi Mala like this, written Trinadapi Sunichena. You know, just writing. Of course, physically may not be practical, but in the heart we should always be thinking, I am the lowest, I am the lowest. You see, the water will always flow from a higher altitude to a lower altitude. So the more you are claiming, the more you are fallen, the more you are claimed to receive the mercy of Chaitanya. Okay, any last questions or comments? Yes, Swayam Prakash Prabhu.
What exactly is this humility?
Maybe proud or even like being soft, that is also the thing. Some people are proud of their humility. I am the most humble. It's a very good point you made. Even if I do have some trace of humility, let us come by the causeless mercy of my spiritual master. If I do have some good qualities, like I am soft-spoken, I am gentle, I am mitbhuk, I eat in a controlled way. These are all the causeless mercy of my spiritual master. Do not be proud of borrowed plumes. Like somebody just takes some, suppose you take some ornaments from somebody and decorate yourself, or if you are in, probably you will take some coat from another person and decorate them. Like suppose I am driving I cannot afford a small Alto also, but somebody has a Fortuner, 25 lakh, I am just driving that and think it's mine. So I am just a driver. So it actually belongs to the owner. So, if at all I do have qualification, it is the mercy of my spiritual master. Okay? Anybody like to add something? Or? So, we'll continue the next verse. Actually, in this one verse, I'm sorry, one more point in the purport to the present verses. Bharat Bhumiti Haile Manushya Janma Jaya. Prabhupada is making very clear. Especially asking those who are born in India. I think most of you are born in India. So it applies to all of us. In fact, when Prabhupada started the mission, he told the devotees to chant 64 rounds. The devotees said, no, we are very busy. We have so many other things to do. Prabhupada said, all right, 32 rounds. No, we are born in, most of the devotees at that time from Western background. We are from Western background. So Prabhupada said, all right, 16 and no less. These devotees did a good job. They got a good deal, 75% discount. You get something costing 64 rupees for 16 rupees. And if Prabhupada would have allowed, they would have gone down to one or two also. Prabhupada said 16 and no less. But then he told in one lecture, I have kept 16 because Westerners feel burdened to chant more. In other words, Prabhupada is expecting more from those who are born in Bharat Varsh. He's saying 16 for those who are born in Western countries. So Prabhupada made a common standard. But for those of you born in Bharat Varsh, if you can do more, it's wonderful. You see, I always see it like this, that there's a certain goal I have to reach. Like I have to go from here, let's say, to Mysore. If I go at good speed, then I can reach in 2-3 hours, right? Average speed of it's about how much? 140 kilometers from here, Mysore. 180. 145, yes. Prabhu, yes. Precisely like a mathematician, yes. 145. So if I go at the speed of 50, I can reach in 3 hours. But if I go at the speed of 25, it will take 6 hours. Or if I go in a bullock cart speed, then I may reach tomorrow. So I have a certain goal to reach in spiritual life. If I am chanting 16 rounds, that means I will be reaching after certain births. But if I can make it 25, then I will reach faster. If I can do 32, it's even better. But not neglecting the material responsibilities, which are also part of devotion and service. For a housewife to cook is also devotional service. For a husband to earn money is also devotional service. Because that is nihit kartavya, that is part of varnashram. But we should try to adjust things in such a way that we have more time for hearing chant. Is that okay? Yes, Prabhu. That is part of service. Devotional service includes chanting. In fact, Lord Chaitanya says the most important item of devotional service is chanting. In the beginning, I think you may have missed it out. In the beginning, I quoted that verse. Taramade sarvashrishta nama sankirtan. Many times people think that service means something practical, like I get some money, I cook something. And this chanting and sitting, this is not service. Both are service. Cooking prasad is also service, eating prasad is also service, easy one. And chanting is also service, hearing is also service. But chanting is what makes all other services devotional service. If you are not chanting, then you may do service, but it cannot be counted strictly as devotional service. So, you see, it depends on one's ashram, varna, practical duties. I am not saying we should neglect other services. Taking care of all the services, whatever time is there, chant more and more. Or sometimes in ashram, like in business, one can work less. You know, you may get a little less, but still be satisfied with that. You may work 8 hours and earn, let's say, 8,000 per day. And if you work 4 hours and get 4,000, you can be satisfied in 4,000. There are people who are satisfied in 4,000 per month also. You know, there's a question of what we need and adjusting. But at least the goal should be there. Okay, we'll read the next verse. हरिदास इफ यू हैव इन योर मोबाइल प्लीज गो टू द वर्स आफ्टर दिस वन हरिदास कहे प्रभु चिंता न करी यवने र संसार देखी दुख न भावी यस अवर राइट प्रभु कैन रीड राइट यू लाइक टू रीड No, translation.
Haridas Thakur replied, My dear Lord, do not be in anxiety.
Same Prakash Prabhu.
Do not be unhappy to see the condition of the Yavanas.
I just always say, Murari, what is name? Murari? The devotee name is? So, this is Haridas. Thakur is saying, do not be in anxiety, seeing the condition of the Yavanas. Muli Mahal Prabhu can read the purport. Let read the purport. Very important part of the purport is the devotee is trying to reduce the anxiety of the Lord. Haridas is telling, my dear Lord, chinta na kariha. Generally we say, Lord says, ma shucha. When you go to Ati Vardaraj, the Kanchipuram temple, the deity on the hand is written, ma shucha. Do not worry, do not be in anxiety. Now the role is reversed. The devotee is telling the Lord, do not be in anxiety. And Prabhupada makes a very beautiful point. In the purport, Prabhupada says, please read very carefully, says that everyone should adopt the cause of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to try to relieve him from anxiety. This is actually service to the Lord. We were discussing about what is service, you know. It is service to the Lord to encourage each other in hearing and chanting also. Lord Krishna says, who is the devotee who is most dear to me? One who cooks rasgullas, no? One who preaches to, one who preaches my glories to, not others, to my devotees. Who said? My devotees. Perfect. You see, more important than preaching to newcomers is to preach to devotees. And preaching doesn't mean taking a superior role. I will be giving the lecture, but I should think I am a servant of the devotees. Preaching also means an individual, one-to-one preaching. You meet your, you know, devotee colleague, or whom you know, just think about Krishna, just talk some story you have read. So this is the greatest service. Generally we think service means good practical result, anachi. You know, like how much books, how much money, how much like visible. But real, that is also service. But most important service is to inspire each other. Machitta, madgata, prana, bodhayanta, parasparam. So Prabhupada writes in the purport, this is actual service to the Lord. One who tries to relieve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's anxiety for the fallen souls is a most dear and confidential devotee of the Lord. Why do we sing this verse? You know, Sakshad Haritvena Samasta Shastre Uktastatha Bhavyata Eva Sadbhir. We sing this. What is the meaning of this verse? Spiritual master is as good as Lord Hari. Why? Because he is performing this service of preaching. So what we are doing in ISKCON, we are assisting the spiritual master. So we don't become proud. I am not preaching, Prabhupada is preaching. I am assisting the servants of Prabhupada. So last part Prabhupada says, we should never blaspheme such a devotee. Sometimes we become envious of other devotees who have more success. Sometimes we go to the extent of inhibiting others preaching also. People should not go to his program. You know, they may be bereft of Krishna consciousness, doesn't matter, but they should not go to their program. We become envious. Why people are going to his program? No. We want people to become connected to Krishna, somehow or other. A good doctor will think the patient should be cured, either with my medicine or his medicine. Or a very competitive, selfish doctor may think he should come to me only. If he's not coming to me, let him die, that is better. But he should not go to the other doctor. You know? The preachers should never be envious of each other. Prabhupada says in the purport, that is the greatest offense, to become envious of devotees. First now, blaspheme devotees. Okay, I will pause to go to this book, which hopefully next time I come. Those of you like a copy, please, Neminath Prabhu can collect the names, because I have about 10 copies. This book is 250 rupees, but the newer edition is with a thinner paper, so it costs around 80 to 100 rupees. So those of you like, and please, I tell you, this book will make a gulf of difference in your chanting, from what I've experienced. So I'm taking one sample from this book, where it talks about how to overcome offenses. Earlier, if you remember, I had told that one process, one way to overcome offenses was chant 1.5 hours a day, continuously. How many hours? Try for 24 hours, yes. But now I'll tell you another secret, how to overcome offenses. This is from Adi Leela of Chaitanya Charitamrita. If you have Chaitanya Charitamrita in your mobile, then you can switch it on to Adi Leela, 8th chapter. And this is verse number 24. Adi Leela, 8th chapter. Verse number 24. Okay, everybody got it? Gopinath Pran Prabhu? Like to read that verse? You can read the Bengali. 8th chapter. Verse number 24. Everybody repeat. Krishna nama kare. Please read the translation. We are chanting Hare Krishna, but we are not feeling ecstasy. Why? Because of the offenses. Now, next paragraph. Maybe Prabhu, you'd like to read? Oh. How to overcome offenses. It is loudly. It is very beneficial, that one. This is a very important paragraph. In this, actually, everything is there. Now, whatever is going to be told, the same thing will be repeated, and like, you know, we have the essence and then some fragrance and some dry fruits are being added. But in one paragraph of Purport, which you so nicely read, it is said that one very beneficial to just say Shri Krishna, even if you cannot say the, of course, we should say the whole Panchatattva mantra. Shri Krishna, Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita, Gadadhar, Srivas Adi Gaur Bhakti. If you cannot say the whole thing, if you just say this also, you become ecstatic. Now, the next paragraph, the whole, it's a very long purport. I am not going into it because of limitation of time. But there are 10 offenses which are discussed. Now, we'll go to the next verse. Next verse is slightly difficult to recite, but we can certainly read the translation. Who is the next devotee you like to read the translation? Neminath Prabhu, please read the translation.
One's heart does not change, tears do not flow from his eyes, his body does not shiver, and his bodily cares do not stand on the end as he chants the Hare Krishna Gauranga. It should be understood that his heart is as hard as iron. This is due to his offenses at the speed of Lord's holy name.
Does everybody follow this point? This is from Bhagavatam, second canto, that if one is hearing about Krishna or chanting the holy name, tears would become manifest. If tears are not coming out, body is not shivering, not because of cold, not getting cold in Bangalore, you know, but it is shivering because of ecstasy, and hairs are not standing, that means the heart is like iron. This is due to offenses at the lotus feet of the holy name. Because of time, we are not going to the purport. But in the purport, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining, the tears should be genuine tears, not artificial. Like sometimes sahajiyas, you know, they force, some other they'll put something in the eyes, the tears will come out. That is not genuine. But real tears means one should be genuinely engaged in devotional service. What is the sign of advancement is avyartha kalam. What does avyartha kalam mean? Not wasting even a moment. And nama gana sada ruchi. What does it mean? Nama gana sada ruchi. Always having taste for hearing, chanting. Now we go to the next verse. Eka Krishna nama kare sarva papa nasha. Premira karana bhakti korena prakasha. Now one of the Matajis can begin, read the translation.
Simply chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra without offenses vanquishes all sinful activities. Thus, pure devotional service, which is the cause of love of God.
So here, the effect is described of chanting Hare Krishna Mantra without offense. That sentence is very important. Without offense. Like if I'm trying to cook something, and then as the fire is lighted up, immediately I put water on it, then again I cook, then again water, then nothing will become manifest. So we are chanting Hare Krishna, similarly doing offenses. That is why the result of chanting is not manifest. That's why, as I told you, many devotees leave, they find 25 years down the line, they have been chanting, but no result is coming. Because what happens after 1 or 2 years, then we become engaged in practical service, so result oriented. How much did I do? How many devotees did I make? How many books distributed? Now, these are also important things. Prabhupada wanted these things. But most important Prabhupada wanted is that we chant with quality. In one lecture, Prabhupada says, our chanting like should be like the child crying for mother. Should be with genuine feelings. You know? So, we will not go into the purport of this verse. But the last part of the purport, Prabhupada says, if one chants the holy name, gradually one will become free from all sinful reaction. We go to the next verse. Premera Uday Hai Premera Vikara Shweda Kampa Pulakadi Gadgad Ashrudhara. This Prabhupada read, this symptom should not be imitated. Actually, Prabhupada never showed these symptoms publicly. But one day he was in Gorakhpur. Anybody know the story in Gorakhpur? Prabhupada was singing. What was he singing? Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihar. You know Prabhupada's bhajans. There's a few. Recently I made a collection of 50 bhajans of Prabhupada. If you like, after the lecture you can take from my mobile. I keep it. Very deep singing. Prabhupada would sing, you know, when he was chanting Vandeham. Vandeham Shri Guru. I'm just trying to imitate. But Prabhupada, so depth in his chanting. And Yamuna Mataji, also one devotee, remarking, sometimes Prabhupada would ask her to lead Kirtan. And she was like completely absorbed. Just complete, perfect example of absorption in chanting. We can take inspiration from such Prabhupada and their disciples. So, Prabhupada was in Gorakhpur and he just, Jai Radha Madhava, and suddenly he just could not control himself. And tears started coming out of his eyes, and then he told the devotees, just chant Hare Krishna. He said, in this song, Jai Radha Madhava, everything is there. There is Govardhan, there is Yamuna, there is Gopis, everything is there. Another instance in America, in Atlanta, Prabhupada was singing that famous song of Paramakaruna Pahudui Jana Nitai Gaurachandra. And as he sang, he became completely ecstatic. He said, Lord Chaitanya is so merciful. He has come all the way to this remote place in America. Prabhupada is calling America a remote place. And Mayapur is the real place. You know. He has come to him and he could not control himself. But generally a devotee does not show symptoms, because what happens, people will imitate it just to get some cheap adoration, distinction. The story of Haridas Thakur, you know, somebody was trying to imitate. And Haridas Thakur came to a place and there was a snake charmer, you know, Saperia in Hindi they say, Garud. They blow up the, such a way that the snake is controlled. And he was singing a song where it was describing how Lord Krishna is dancing on the hoods of Kaliya. And Haridas Thakur heard this. Being a pure devotee, his mind became completely absorbed. He just started crying. He fell to the ground, unconscious, rolling on the ground. And all the devotees in the snake charmer were watching. They just stood by the side very reverentially, very respectfully. And then Haridas Thakur suddenly left. And there was an imitation Brahman who was thinking, I will also do like this. He also jumped up, then he also fell down. And the snake charmer took a stick and beat him up. And he ran for his life. Other devotees were shocked. They said, oh, there is one devotee, he is showing some symptoms and you are watching it with great reverence. Another devotee is showing the same symptom and they are beating him with the sticks. Why is it so? The snake charmer became very happy. He said, I am very happy you asked this question, because you are giving me the chance to speak about Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur is such a great devotee that even Lord Brahma and Shiva like to have his association. Mother Ganga is waiting, when will Haridas come and bathe in my water to purify me? He never offends devotees. He serves Lord Hari and devotees. That's why it's called Haridas. Anybody who once chants the name of Haridas, Jai Jai Haridas, Jai Jai Haridas, Jai Jai Haridas, he goes to Vaikuntha. You chanted three times, that means you go to Goloka, you know. And this other Brahman is hypocrite. He just wanted to make a big show. That's why I beat him up. So we cannot, you know, Prabhupada says that we cannot imitate. Now we'll go fast because it's coming close to time. Tomorrow, shall we start at 8 o'clock? What is good, like, can start at 8 or 8:30 or 9? 8 o'clock is practical. And of course, prasadam is there after the class. So, you know, you don't. Of course, you have to cook for some devotees who cannot come, family members. We'll do one or two more verses and end today's session. Anayase bhavachaya krishne rasevana. Ek krishna namera phale pai ete dhana. Please read the translation.
As a result of chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, one makes such great advancement in spiritual life that simultaneously his material existence terminates and he receives love about it. The holy name of Krishna is so powerful that by chanting even one name, one very easily achieves these transcendental riches.
Yeah. So this is the result of true chanting, you know. But he will feel the symptoms. We'll go to the next verse. Hena Krishna nama yadi laye bara bara. Tabu yadi premanahi nahi ashrudhara. Tabe jani aparada tahate prachura. Krishna nama bijatahe nakare ankura. Nandana Chair Prabhu, you like to read? It's because he is chanting, but because of the offenses, the seed is not sprouting. We put the seed, put some water, it starts sprouting after a few days. But it's not sprouting. Same Prakash Prabhu, you can read the purport. Yes, very small purport is there. If one chants the holy name. Now we come to the last verse of today's discussion, very important. Chaitanya Nityananda nahi esaba vichara. Namalaite premade bahi ashrudhara. Yes, Sarva Prabhu. Yeah, she said, with slight faith, if you just say the name Gauranga and Nityananda, then gradually all offenses will go away. Then after that you chant Hare Krishna. Now this purport is very, very important. I will read it. Please listen attentively. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur remarks in this connection that if one takes shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda, how to take shelter? Next line. Follow their instruction to become more tolerant than tree and humbler than the grass. And in this way chants the holy name, very soon he will achieve the platform of transcendental loving service to the Lord and tears will appear in his eyes. You followed? What is the qualification? To take shelter of Gaur Nitai by becoming humble like a blade of grass more torn than a tree. Now read the next line. There are offenses to be considered in chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, but there are no such considerations in chanting the name of Gaur Nityananda. Therefore, if one chants the Hare Krishna mantra, but his life is still full of sinful activities, it will be very difficult for him to achieve the platform loving service to the Lord. But if in spite of being an offender, one chants the holy name of Gauranga and Nityananda, he is very quickly freed from the reaction to his offenses. Therefore, one should first approach Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda or worship Guru Gauranga and then come to the stage of worshipping Radha Krishna. In our Krishna conscious movement, our students are first advised to worship Guru Gauranga, and then when they are somewhat advanced, then Radha Krishna deity is installed and they are engaged in the worship of the Lord. So, in Krishna naam kare aparadera vichar, but Gaur Nityananda naam, no offense. You know this song by Bhaktivinoda Thakur in this connection? Which is the song by Bhaktivinoda Thakur which talks about offenses to the holy name and how Gaur Nityananda do not take offense? Doyal Nitai Chaitanya Bhole Nacharya Marma. In that it says, O Name Aparade Vichar To Nai Hai. O Name, which name? Gaur Nitai's name. Aparadhan. Aparada Dure Jabe Pabe Premadhan. So if you chant Hare Krishna for 108 lives, but if you are offending, unknowingly or knowingly, you will not get it. But if you chant the name of Gaur Nityananda before chanting Hare Krishna, then all offenses are forgiven. And now we come to the next paragraph. One should first take shelter of Gaur Nityananda in order to ultimately reach Radha Krishna. Narottam Das Thakur says, Gauranga bolite habe pulaka sharira hari hari bolite nayane babe neera. What he is saying is that when that time will come when I chant the name of Gauranga and tears will come out of my eyes and my body will be shivering in ecstasy. Next paragraph, next line of the song. Ar kabe nitai chander karuna koribe sansara vasana mora kabe tuchha habe. That means when will Lord Nityananda be merciful to me? And what will happen if he is merciful? I will get crores of rupees. Sansara vasana tuchha habe. Lose desire for wealth and position. And last line is more important. Vishaya chhadiya kabe shuddha habe mana kabe hama heribo Shri Vrindavan. Many of you are planning to go to Vrindavan for Kartik. How we go to Vrindavan? Vishaya chhadiya. Give up the desire for sense gratification and shuddha habe mana, purify the mind. Now please listen, this next paragraph is even more important. This purport is, if you should read this purport at least once in a month or twice a month, it will help you. In the beginning, one should very regularly chant Shri Gaur Sundar's name and then chant the name of Lord Nityananda. Thus, one's heart will be cleansed of impure desires for material enjoyment. Then one can approach Vrindavan Dham to worship Lord Krishna. Unless one is favored by Lord Chaitanya Nityananda, there is no need to go to Vrindavan. For unless his mind is purified, he cannot see Vrindavan even if he goes there. So Prabhupada writes here that going to Vrindavan means that take shelter of Gaur Nitai. The next line is even more deeper. Actually, going to Vrindavan involves taking shelter of the six Goswamis by reading the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Vidagdha Madhava, Lalita Madhava and other books that they have given. In this way, one can understand the transcendental loving affairs between Radha and Krishna. Kabe hum bheji bo se yugala priti. The conjugal love between Radha and Krishna is not an ordinary human affair. It is fully transcendental. In order to understand Radha and Krishna, worship them and engage in their service, one must be guided by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu and the six Goswamis, Lord Chaitanya's direct disciples. Now I remember once Prabhupada was in Madras and one life member said, Swamiji, speak something about Radha Krishna Leela. Prabhupada just evaded the topic. No, speak something. Prabhupada finally said, you may be qualified to understand, but I am not qualified to speak. So generally Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never spoke Radha Krishna Leela. If Prakashan Saraswati, he didn't speak. Only with Raya Ramananda he spoke Radha Krishna Leela. Because he is very intimate. So otherwise he would give general lectures on the holy name. But when it comes to confidential Leela of Radha and Krishna, that is not to be discussed ordinarily. Now this next point is important. For an ordinary man, worship of Gaur Nitai Prabhu and Panchatattva is easier than worship Radha Krishna. It's like here we have Gaur Nitai Jagannath, but we are not having Radha Krishna. Actually, unless we are qualified, we should not worship Radha Krishna. Why? Unless one is very fortunate, he should not be induced to worship Radha Krishna directly. A neophyte student who is not sufficiently educated or enlightened should not indulge in the worship of Radha Krishna or the chanting of Hare Krishna mantra. Very shocking. Prabhupada is saying neophyte devotee should not chant Hare Krishna. Then how will he become advanced? That means he should not chant Hare Krishna mantra directly. First he should chant Panchatattva mantra. Even if he does so, suppose he chants Radha Krishna name, he cannot get the desired result. One should therefore chant the names of, what does Prabhupada say? Nitai Gaura, and worship them without false prestige. Since everyone within this material world is more or less influenced by sinful activities, in the beginning it is essential that one take to the worship of Guru Gauranga, ask their favor, for that despite all the disqualification, one will become very soon qualified to worship of Radha Krishna Vig. Does everybody follow this point? Now we come to the last paragraph of today's discussion. This is really last. I've been saying last for a long time. Any comments about what we discussed so far? Ashok Gaur Prabhu, any comments? Maybe, I mean, I have not heard, it must be since you are saying, but Prabhupada says that clearly that before Hare Krishna should chant the Panchatattva mantra. But your explanation is very good. It requires little advancement to understand, but it is certainly true. Any comments or questions by Matajis? Anything you may like to add? Or this should be, of course, I expect tomorrow you will be more participative, because this is not just a Bhagavatam class. First of all, Bhagavatam class gets over in 9 o'clock. Why I kept like this is it's more of a discussion. And I specially chose to come at this time. So you can think of something and whatever you have heard and share. Okay, now we come to the last paragraph, really last paragraph. It should be noted in this connection that the holy names of Lord Krishna and Gaurasundara are both identical with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, one should not consider one name to be more potent than another. Now, just see Prabhupada is saying that first he says that chanting Gauranga name is more important. But then he says, you should not think Gauranga is more potent than Krishna. Bhagavan mein jhagda mat paida karo, you know. Jai Gaura, Sei Krishna, Sei Jagannath. But then the next line is again different. He says, considering the position of people in this age, you know how exalted they are. So, the chanting of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's name is more essential than the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the most magnanimous incarnation and his mercy is verily achieved. Prabhupada is saying chanting Gauranga's name is more important than chanting Hare Krishna Mantra. So, one devotee argued, Prabhupada, then why can't we just chant Gaura Gaura Nitya Nitai? Prabhupada says, no, don't concoct. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling to chant Hare Krishna, so we should chant Hare Krishna. And the last line, therefore, one must first take shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by chanting Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrind. By serving Lord Gaur Nityananda, one is freed from the entanglement of material existence and thus become qualified to worship Radha Krishna deity. So, the conclusion is that by taking shelter of Lord Chaitanya Nityananda, by chanting the Panchatattva mantra in the beginning of every mala, we do that. In fact, Prabhupada's Gurudev Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says that every bead, as you are touching the bead, you can think you are touching the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And there is a beautiful verse which supports this fact. It says, Dushkaram Sukaram Bhavit. The most difficult things become easy. How? By remembering Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And the most easy things become difficult by forgetting Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we should, in conclusion, always remember Lord Gauranga. I think the voice is so low, like you're fasting for 3 days. You know, Shri Japatak Maharaj is about to come, we should chant loudly, Gauranga! 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 So let us end with a prayer to Supreme Lord that we get His mercy. Just 2 minutes of kirtan, which I always do in the end, is sitting kirtan. When I'm chanting, you fold your hands and you can raise your arms. Very short kirtan, just with a prayer, Lord, let me follow this instruction which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given, which Prabhupada is giving, and attain pure chant. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya
Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda. Please raise your arm. Jaya Shri Krishna Hey Gauranga, hey Nityananda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Rama 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 Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna He Gauranga
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Last time, we chant together, please. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hey Gauranga, help me, please help me.
Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare. Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai, Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai. Jaya Jagannatha, Jaya Jagannatha, Baladeva, Jaya Subhadra. Jai 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 Prabhupada, 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 Jai Srila Prabhupada.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna. Thank you.